In the name of the Father, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. We are celebrating a day to the Saturday, 12th of May, 1973. Saturday, 12th of May, 1973, as 46 years ago, when history was made in this country. Our founding fathers presented to the world, to the state, Midwestern state there, to the region and to the country, a brand new, well-equipped teaching hospital on that day. So we inside that hospital that was opened that day by Mrs. Victoria Gowon and her husband, the then UBTH has grown since for the past 46 years that we established to be the second largest teaching hospital in the Federal Republic of Nigeria, second only to University College Hospital in Ibadan, that is UBTH Ibadan. So many of us don't realize this, that in terms of bed capacity, we are 850-bedded hospital. There's no other hospital that is as big as that. And in terms of utilization and bed occupancy rates, we believe there's no other hospital that have as high as us. In terms of utilization, at any point in time, our bed occupancy rate is in the range of 70-75%, which is extremely high. Of recent, we know how the epileptic, the power supply, UBTH in the ministry, and in those states has been. For 3 months on, probably will not have light for more than a few hours. Nobody has ever asked us, how do you manage to keep your light on? Looking after 500 patients, as we speak, we have about 500 and something patients in our wards. How do you keep your light on that it doesn't blink? If you detect light within a few seconds, nobody asks, how do you do all these things? So we have a lot to be thankful to God for. We have a lot to let our people know. And we know our society holds us to high standard and we welcome it. We welcome it, but it's also important that we contextualize what we are doing. Now, in the environment we operate in, keeping such standards is an equivalent task. And it's time people start appreciating the effort that goes into such standards that we are keeping. Even private hospitals, but it never takes life for, I mean, the best running private hospitals, they still switch off their generator. Well, UBTH, we don't.
When the people around you are happy, you know that you are doing good. But if they squeeze their eyes, whenever they see you or maybe see other people, you know that there is something wrong. However, you are doing good, and I want you to continue in this field. Your staff and people in society you serve, they believe that maybe when they come here, there will be daily infrastructure for their stomach. And the society you serve, they also come here to come and receive treatment so that they can get away. When issues are very, very critical in some private and general hospital in Benin, they refer them to this place. Even around the cities. So I want you to continue with that faith. If they do not believe that they are going to have treatment, good treatment in the University of Benin, Benin Teaching Hospital, nobody will send his patient to this place. Then, the turning around, especially on the social and humanitarian program, which you have processed your assumption of tenure's office, it has been very remarkable.
I think this is because I'm a beneficiary of the NHIS stuff. You see that you come, it now, when it started, Mr. Jim, I know Jim right from the NHIS area. And when it started, you come and you assess the and drugs are given. You know, you pay a token and you go. But these days have never come in the last 3 years now and go back without stay for about 3 hours. So I begin to wonder, why is it so? That is on one hand. Then on the second hand, you see that the drug they give you today is not the same drug they will give you tomorrow. They will be telling you this is alternative drugs for that one the doctor has written. So sir, is the NHIS stuff dying or you are going to revive it? Because I'm no longer enjoying it. The initial time I was, and everybody is come, not just me, and I have opportunity to say this before you. For those that also come like myself, I equally not happy.
Miracles will perform on the ones. The ones that is already half dead or quarter dead that they bring here, especially with that. That's what everybody will shout about. Even the ones you see in social media, they won't tell you that they were in a private hospital. The whole popular one who mentioned, who had a terminal ailment, metastatic cancer. And he has been changing treatment every other place. At the point in that metastatic, that is, that spread around the whole body, you come to UBTH and you put UBTH under enormous pressure and you expect us to perform magic and miracle. We did try. So the bulk of the deaths you see in UBTH are because of this late reference. I don't think it's true that there are more delays now than before. I don't want to question it, but you see, we see like 2,400 patients, outpatients every day. Every day. So that number, thereabouts, that number, if it's a big hospital, huge, that number, there will definitely be issues here and there. But one of the things we are looking at, you mentioned jimoh, who was the head of Servicom at the state level. Thank you for mentioning him. Servicom, when jimoh was the head, UBT was number one in the whole Federal Republic of Nigeria in terms of service delivery. And I believe they come back now, we are almost there again. So, our number of enrollees, I've just been told now, have increased from 10,000 to 35,000. There's a huge increase in number of enrollees. That's also an attestation of confidence in what we are doing. There's a lot of pressure on our services. Let's be honest with ourselves. Our staff, they are overworked. I've said it again and again. They are not enough. Our nurses, we just have 700 nurses. Remember I told you we have 500 patients in the world. So we have 500 nurses, 700 and something nurses looking after 500 patients. Let me tell you what that means. You don't know what that means. You think that it's one-to-one. No, it's not. Out of that 700 nurses, some of them are running clinics. They are the nurses you see in the audit. We have so many clinics, GPC, consultant pay clinic, NHIS clinic. So it's not all the 700 nurses are in the world. Out of that 700 nurses, some of them would have to go on off. They do shifts. So by the time you share shifts, you have to imagine how many nurses you have per patient. Meanwhile, hospital, like Shirley mentioned, it's one of the foremost teaching hospitals in Nigeria. They have 1,300 and something nurses. Those are the issues. Our doctors are overworked, our nurses are overworked, our clinical staff are overworked. No, we are not running away from this. And we will need more. We are getting the authorities to employ more, and hopefully they will respond to us. Then NHIS, I was talking about NHIS. When you talk about drug, we have a meeting with them. The law setting up NHIS says we can only give you drug that are what we call generic. They don't have brand. For example, Panadol is the brand name. Paracetamol, I believe, is a generic name. So anybody can make paracetamol. But not everybody can make Panadol, because Panadol is made by one specific company. I'm promoting somebody, I hope not. So, I just explain. So the law says generic only. Of course, you know the brand, their products are far more expensive than the generic product. We realize that we're losing money on NHIS. We're bleeding, not losing. Most at the state, UBTH, I told you we are working more. But that also implies that we are making more money, isn't it? At the stage, about 2-3 months ago, we sat down as a team. Where is all this money going to? Because you can see, we're always growing, we're always owing people here and there. we now looked at ourselves, found out that because of this number, 10,000, we found out that we actually using our money to be treating NHIS patients. The money was not coming back. And we are still on it.